Good morning, everyone. My name is Rachel. I'm going into year 14 and I'm part of the Mental Health and Wellbeing Action Group at Friends. I hope that you're all keeping well and staying safe, as well as enjoying the nice weather and slight ease to the lockdown rules these past few weeks. This week, from the 1st to the 5th of June, Friends will be hosting our own Take 5 Week, with each day focusing on a different aspect of mental wellbeing under the titles Connect, Take Notice, Be Active, Keep Learning, and Give. Hopefully you will have seen the posters on Google Classroom advertising the range of activities planned, from TikTok challenges to Taekwondo, calligraphy to upcycling your old clothes. There's plenty to try your hand at. And with a week off, homework and lessons, I really encourage you to make the most of the opportunities that this event will give us all and to get involved as much as possible.
So what is mental wellbeing? Mental wellbeing is defined as a state in which someone knows his or her own ability and can cope with the normal stresses of life. In other words, it is about your thoughts and feelings and how you cope with the ups and downs of the everyday. Firstly, it is important to note that although the two can influence each other, mental wellbeing is not the same as mental health. Long periods of low mental wellbeing can lead to the development of a diagnosable mental health condition, such as anxiety or depression. If you're living with a mental health condition, it is completely normal for you to experience low mental wellbeing more often. Although this does not mean that it is impossible for you to experience periods of good mental wellbeing too. Secondly, and importantly, good mental wellbeing is not the absence of negative thoughts and feelings. We all face challenging and difficult situations that may cause us to feel angry, upset, overwhelmed, and everything in between. Instead, mental wellbeing is about being able to understand and manage those feelings, so that generally you're able to feel confident in yourself, build and maintain positive relationships, have a sense of purpose, live and work productively, and be able to cope with everyday stresses.
The COVID-19 pandemic has undoubtedly had an impact on everyone's daily lives. In these challenging and unprecedented times, we may experience increased levels of stress, anxiety, low mood, or depression. However, this is not uncommon, and we want you to know that you are not alone. During this time, you may feel bored, frustrated, or lonely, or perhaps you're concerned about your health or that of those that are close to you. Everyone reacts differently to events and changes in life, which influence the way we think, feel, and behave. Therefore, it's so important to take care of your mind as well as your body and to seek further support if you need it. At Friends, we want to do everything we can to help remove the stigma that often surrounds mental health. This year, a committee of Year 13 pupils and staff have established a mental health and wellbeing action group in school, and we hope that it will benefit the school community as a whole. Even in this time of separation, we want to emphasise that you are not alone. Please know that there is always someone to help you and to talk to if you need to chat. You can contact the school's pastoral care team by email or by phone, and the details for this and for Childline will be at the end of this video.
You may have watched the documentary Football, Prince William and Our Mental Health last week. This highlighted the importance of breaking the taboo around the issue. In our silence, please reflect on a few lines from the programme. If you are a person that is struggling, please never feel guilty or ashamed about feeling like you are, or to share your true emotions with those who are closest to you. You're so much stronger than you could ever imagine, and although you may not be able to see it right now, that cloud hanging over your head has a silver lining. Stay strong and stay safe.
Thank you. We hope that you'll find this week to be both enjoyable and helpful. Members from the Wellbeing Action Group will now introduce in more detail the plans and activities for the week ahead. Have a great week and stay safe.
Hi everyone.
Welcome to day one of our FSL Wellbeing Week, Connect.
It's all about taking the opportunity to get in touch and connect during this time.
Our activities today include a TikTok challenge, writing to residents of a nursing home, and a year group quiz.
More important than ever that we stay connected with each other.
We hope you enjoy our day. Bye!
Bye!
Welcome to day two of Mental Wellbeing Week.
Today is day two, take notice. Today we want you to take notice of your surroundings and your feelings.
Today we want to take time for yourself. Why not try some breathing, exercises or yoga outside?
We'd also really love for you to express your feelings by getting them out there. We thought that journaling was the best way to do this, so we've put together a short hand lettering and calligraphy video to help you do this.
For many people, music can be a way to help them express their feelings and to also lift their mood.
For our Take Notice Day on Tuesday, we've created a Spotify profile called Mental Health Awareness. It includes two playlists, Relax and Feel Good, both of which you can choose through and select which one you like. They both include feel good music to promote mental wellbeing.
Another aspect of our Take 5 Day is we encourage you to get out and explore your surroundings by taking a walk or cycle. This can help you to de-stress and relax.
We also set you the challenge to take photos of the scenery you find on your walks and send these to your Google Classrooms or to our Instagram account at FSL_mental health.
Hi everyone. So on Wednesday of our Take 5 week, we have our Be Active Day. This focuses on the importance of exercise on our own mental health. On Wednesday, several different events will be taking place, and some of these include Mr. Robinson's fitness challenges, including a 5K run, which you will be able to complete and then submit your times, and then the winner will get a bit of a shout out. Mr. Monaghan and the rest of the PE staff will also be hosting the Circa Rovers class on Zoom, and it would be great if you could join us. There will also be a pre-recorded Taekwondo lesson, and it would be great if you could follow along, courtesy of Lisburn Taekwondo Club. Finally, we will have a Q&A session with the PE staff and a couple of members of our senior hockey teams who are also in Ulster Development Squads, discussing the topic of sport and mental health. Thank you, see you soon.
Hey everyone, we hope you're as well as you can be with the current situation.
Thursday's focus is Keep Learning, and so throughout the day we hope that you will try and participate in the various opportunities that we have available.
On our day, whether you bake a cake, try a funny drawing or learn to count to five in another language, make sure you share what you've done with us. And don't forget, the main aim of the day is to learn something new.
From our team to yours, we hope you enjoy a Keep Learning Day.
Day 5 of our Take 5 week is called Give. It's all about giving and being generous. Three main points, which are giving money, which focusing mainly on charities and the NHS and things like that. Resources, which is more practical, more about the physical things that we own, so food banks or household supplies for different charities and stuff like that. And then our time, which is mainly centered around people that we spend our time with and how we can be generous by giving up our time to others.